Hello. I came out to the garage to do something else and I ended up doing a little job that I've been meaning to do, and that is strengthening the engine adapter for the flathead engine stand. What you can see, I've got a piece of flat metal there. It's a quarter inch thick, and I've welded it to the angle iron to kind of make it into a triangular box section in effect. So I'm hoping that that will do. You can see it's still steaming, still smoke coming off it. I've just finished welding it. I didn't want to film the welding because, to be honest, you just can't see anything. That was the first weld there. Can you see how it's gone a little? It's a little bit cold, but I thought I'd do the first weld in the most the least critical part. By the time I did that one and then a bit of heat got into the job, the rest kind of went okay. The flat material is actually a leaf spring. I don't know what it was from, but I've just used that. It's a little bit light now, but I need to just dress this weld flat. Dress these welds flat so that it bolts onto the engine stand adapter okay. And I'm hoping now that that will cut down on that flexing problem that I was having. Well, it wasn't flexing, it was bending. The ends of the angle iron were twisting. Hopefully that'll be okay. I do quite well with this welder, to be honest. It's only 130 amp pocket turbo 130, but this is a Sabora, Italian Sabora. Now these are marketed as a snap-on in Europe. Well, I've had this over 20 years. 20 years ago, this is what was sold by snap-on, a Sabora. So yeah, good. Okay, I'll let that all cool down then and see how I get on when I come to bolt it on. And see how it gets on when it comes to bolting an engine onto it next time. Maybe I might put something from there down to there. Yeah, I might strengthen it a bit more. I'll have to find some suitable material. But I think that'll make a big difference because it's now a triangular box section in effect. Okay, right, just a quickie then. Just get another little job knocked out. Okay. Righto then. See you later then. Bye. Hello, it's the day after. Here's my piece of plate that I've, well, it's actually a piece of leaf spring that I've welded onto there. I've ground these down just so that they would go flush, and this will go on there now, nice and flat. But I've just done a further little bit of bracing and strengthening. I've welded those strengthening pieces on there, that one and that one. I had a little bit of a problem getting the weld into that corner down there, but I'm sure it's going to be stronger than it would be if it wasn't there at all. So I'm just going to give this a little lick with a grinder. But to be honest, I think my little 130 amp MIG has coped well there, you know, with that good thick material. You know, those are decent welds, I'd say, as a non-welder. And all these little, write that off. And all these extra pieces were made from an old leaf spring. Why it's not want not. So you can't say that it's not good material. Okay, so hopefully my engine, my flathead engine adapter will live to see another day. Just a little quickie. thanks for joining me in the garage, and you know, hopefully you'll see this in action. Cheers then, bye. These are a pair of studs that are made to go into the exhaust bolt holes, and there's four of these. These two are the 7/16 ones, the other two are the 3/8 ones. And I'll show you what I've done. Can you see that I put a screwdriver slot there? Well, they're not very good. Not good at all. So what I've just done, these are the other two. I've just milled a 5/16 or 8mm hex on the end of those, so that when I want to fit them to the next motor, I can just put them in with a socket, nice and easy. So there's two that I've done, and there's two that I'm about to do. So what I thought I would do is just set the camera up, and I'll show you the poor man's indexing, hex indexing device. There's a clue. They're in shot. There's your poor man's indexing device there. Okay, I'll set it up and I'll show you how I've been doing it. Now, it was just a matter of luck, but the first two nuts that I put on kind of locked together at a suitable sort of tightness with them aligned. And what you can see here, I've got a lathe tool in there, and I have another nut there. And what I'm going to do first of all, I'm just going to put it in the middle and tighten it, just to sort of snug the nuts down, just in case. I might have had them slightly out. I wonder if maybe that would help to align them. I've got this completely random lathe tool that I've been using as an end stop, like that. So I'll bring that like that, slide that out to it, hold it down with my finger, and let's take some of the slack up. Okay, so that's like that. So we've got, let's say that that's in. I have to make sure I've got this the right way around, like that, with a little groove there. I'll bring that out and then push it back. Bring it out or push it back with the tool till the nut is flush with that cutting face on the tool there, like that. And then, having done two already, I'm hoping that I can repeat the process now. Right, I'm bringing it up to 90, take a little cut. Can you see that? That's just took the threads off. Then I go to about 105, let's say 15 thou. Gets a bit round about 120. Then I have to go to 5 thou past the zero in one smooth movement. Thank you. going to index it round to the next one. Right, let's see if I can. Right, so I've loosened this. That's tight. That's loose. So index it round like that. Snug it down. Get my tool there. That one. Lathe tool. Slide it out. Push it back. Hold it down, tighten it up, and just repeat that 6 times. That's climb milling there, so you don't want to take a heavy cut. Right, so I started at about 90, didn't I? I'll just bring that up and rest it on my shoulder there. You can get like collet blocks and things, but I haven't got anything like that. It's also better to hold the cutter in a collet, but I haven't got a collet to hold this cutter because it's metric. This chuck seems to do pretty well. Fingers crossed it comes out first time. The last two I had to kind of go around and do a little light shave cut at the end, but I'm hoping I've kind of tuned the numbers in now. Keep your fingers crossed. Oh, perfect, look, perfect. That's an 8mm. And that's just with a couple of little bits of swarf on it, so that's alright. A little touch with the file will make that nice and smooth. And that's a 5/16. Yeah, they're both gone, so there you go. That's the job. Whoa. So you can imagine that's going to be far easier to put in and out using a socket. Zip, you know, especially when you got the old brup, brup, brup drill thing. Then, you know, trying to do it with a screwdriver, having to put the two nuts on, lock them together, wind them in and unlock them, wind them out. Okay, so I will, off camera, I will do the last one. But there's the job. It's great having a milling machine, but what I was kind of illustrating there was that this is a poor man's indexing device, using the hex nuts to give you the hex. You go, you know, one flat, one flat, one flat, one flat. So there you are. Look at that. Ace. Okay. Quick little bit of machining there. Cheers then. Bye. Hello. I just lifted the engine block up so I can show the studs being fitted. There's my impact driver. Now one of these ones is a bit bent, or rather can you see when you're working with it in midair like that, hanging on the chain, that it wants to move? That's why it's easier to use the studs, because trying to hold the bracket up and get a bolt through the bracket and into there is virtually impossible. Well, it isn't impossible, it's just awkward. So I thought, well, there's got to be a better way. There we go. So there's a nice little job. Nice bit of machining. Enjoyable time on the milling machine. And improving the shop equipment all the time. Okay. Hope you found that interesting. I'm going to carry on and do something else now, but I'll catch you on the next one. Bye then. Hello. There's the four studs fitted into the block. And I was in the mood for a bit of machining. I've got some of these. These are part of a wheel spacer set for a Mini. This is a 3/8 UNF, and that's a 3/8 UNF. So I drilled all the way through, which popped that off the end. I drilled through 9.8mm, which is the tapping size for a 7/16 UNF. I then ran a tap all the way through, put a 7/16 UNF thread all the way through. So you can imagine that end there is that end there with that piece fallen off, and then the tap, the thread all the way through. I then turned it back to that length, put a little kind of bevel chamfer on there, and put a half inch drill up the end of it to make some clearance there. So from four of those, which I'll never use, I've made four of these. Because there's this plain portion here, I was having to kind of put washers on with my nuts. So these are a slightly bigger hex. These are a 3/4 hex. So I'll put the bracket on, and you'll see where I've had to make a little bit of extra clearance. This is where I've made extra clearance here. So this goes on like this. And these just start on there like that. Nice and easy, because I've got that lead in. And they should be good enough to just come in and put them straight on with this, with the impact wrench. Like that. There we go, as easy as that. So little bit by little bit, I'm improving my shop equipment. I'm pleased with these studs with the hex on it. It's certainly easier than coming up, trying to hold this in mid-air. Bear in mind, it normally has that plate on there as well, the heavier piece. And trying to get a bolt started when this is moving away from you like that. Before you do any of this, obviously you want to put a thread cleaning tap through the threads. So there's my little job that I've done today. I hope you found that interesting. Hope it gives you possibly the idea to maybe, you know, try and make something similar yourself, or your own idea or your own design. That, you know, that's great. Okay, thanks a lot then. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye. My engine stand bracket is really good now. It's really nice and strong. A lot stronger than it was. It was bending, and I strengthened it all up here with these pieces. These pieces and that piece there, that's that strap. And I made these new studs and nuts. Everything works great now. What I just wanted to add to the subject of the engine stand is that all of these are 5/16 and all of these are 3/4. If you're doing it with the bolts, you've got 5/8 AF at this end, 9/16 at this end, and everything's different, and these studs and nuts are really great. I really like using them. Well worth the effort. Okay, right, thanks very much then. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye. Hello, welcome to Mart's Garage. I'm going to try and remove this broken stud. And what I've done is I've drilled it 1/4 inch. Not quite all the way through. And I'm going to try something I haven't done before. I'm going to get my old arc welder fired up. I go straight in there with the thing. And hopefully fill it up with weld from the bottom. I'm hoping that the weld will contract it and then enable it to be removed quite easily. You never know. Look at this thing here. I've had this for, I don't know, at least 40 years, probably longer. It works. Don't know where it's set to. That's quite low actually. Or is that high? Yeah. Oh no, that's max. That's set to max. Close to max anyway. Let's shove this on the tripod. I haven't tried this before. It might not work. And I haven't used the arc welder for a very long time either. I've left the drill base here in case I need to drill it again. I don't think that worked very well. Mm. But nonetheless, let's get the MIG out and try and put some weld on it. I'll take this off, I think. I didn't think that had taken very well. The job's only as good as your initial weld. Yeah, that wasn't very good, was it?
Thank you.
How about that then? It worked. That worked quite well then, because it meant that I didn't waste a lot of nuts and washers and things. There's the piece, look. There's the piece. I think adding that piece on there helped. You saw that I tore this piece off, and there's just a couple of bits of scrap. There's, you know, that's a zero cost extraction, isn't it? Out of all the block, only that one stuck. There's a tiny little bit of weld spatter just above, but by and large the hole is undamaged. You know, I haven't eaten away the edge with weld. Yeah, I think that worked pretty well. Threads are perfect. Because this is the one that goes straight into the exhaust port, isn't it? Okay, just tiny little bit of weld spatter there, look. I don't know if the drilling the hole and trying to put the arc weld down the middle helped in any way at all. I can't tell. You know, if I had to take 12 out and I tried it on 12, I could tell you if it made a difference, but I don't know. Okay. But 100% success rate on one stud. Okay. Righto then, thanks very much for joining me in the garage. Take care and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.